Rejoining us now from our Rockwall studio is Jonas Ravelas, the Chief Market Strategist at BDO Unibank. You heard it there, Jonas, 0.9% for September inflation, far lower than your 1.4% forecast. Will you be revising your inflation forecast then?
Most likely, we'll probably see around 2.7% for end of 2019 and probably stay at 3% for 2020. The present trend will continue to keep the BSP with its easing cycle.
So is that easing cycle going to continue until the end of the year? Or is it going to be for next year? Is the policy rate cutting and triple R cutting going to continue by December?
I think it will continue, but I think probably between now and year end, we'll probably stay at 4% for the policy rate. We will probably see more assessment coming from what's happening overseas now that there's still expectations of probably another cut from the U.S. Fed. So most likely we will see the easing trend to continue and probably spill over to 2020.
Now, how did you come up with the numbers 2.7% for the full year of 2019 with the Banco Central targeting that to end the 2.5%? What are the components that made you decide it could be 2.7?
Most likely, I guess one of the wild cards could still be oil prices. Although definitely compared where the prices were last year, oil remains a wild card. And probably over the next few months, we'll see how the swine flu will probably affect inflation. Although at the moment, we're not actually seeing it.
Mm-hmm. When you say wild card for oil prices, do you have a line in the sand there that you're drawing?
All right. Despite the recent uptick in oil prices, we haven't seen oil, particularly Dubai crude, print below $50. So from a technical perspective, from the charts, it still points to at least there could still be a potential rally to around $80.
All right, and where do you see dollar peso round out the year with the expectations of further cuts in the triple R and the policy rate?
Well, right now, given the present conditions globally, the peso opened at 51.67. We're currently probably looking at closer to an unchanged level at around 52.50 by year end.
And what is that going to do for full year GDP? Can we still reach at least 6% as per government estimates? Or is that going to be a bit of a stretch following the continued underspend on infrastructure?
I think we can still probably try a full 6%, which is very close to our forecast for 2019.
All right, we'll hold you to those forecasts. Thank you so much for joining us, Jonas Ravelas of BDO Unibank in Rockwall.